Hey, what's up, guys? So I started to do an opening video for this. Went ahead and took this landslide apart, and I don't know what the hell I did. Apparently I didn't record, or I had paused it because I was setting up, and I thought I unpaused it, but I didn't. But that goes my life. But anyway, so what we got here is the M2C kit. This is the chassis, the upper plate, and the ESC plate. So what I wanted to do is I never really got a chance to do this properly because when the kit came in, I had already had my landslide set up and I already altered it and all for the testing. So just wanted to show you guys how easy it was to set this thing up and kind of go over the M2C install, because this kit's really a beast and you don't even really need the chassis, but it is a huge upgrade as well. Just really kind of tightens everything down. But yeah, we're going to go ahead and look at this real quick. Basically, all you missed was me dropping every screw off the bottom of the truck, and that's what we got here. I took the bumper and stuff like this off because you got to get to the chassis plate and all to get that piece off the chassis. But this is all the pieces here, and I'm just going to go ahead and start slapping them back onto the new chassis, and then I'm going to install the upper plate and all. We're going to alter this box and show you guys how to alter this. I'll probably want to put in a better servo in this as well while I'm at it. I probably won't upgrade the electronics or anything in this just for what I'm doing. But normally I would probably be upgrading the electronics as I go if it was my truck. But yeah, like I said, either way, I'm going to get back at this. I'll try to do a little fast forwarding, cut into where I need to. But it's pretty cut and dry right now. I've dropped everything off. I'm going to be replacing everything back. And we'll pick up from there. All right, just as easy as it came off, my whole front unit is back on. Normally, if I was doing this M2C kit and I had both pieces, this is where I would want to crack open the other one and go ahead and install the bottom bracket here. So I am not going to do that right now because I want to show you guys the process, basically, of installing a chassis, which we just did, or we're in the process of. And then when I get that done, that will be basically what you need to do from there on out. If you don't want the bottom chassis and you just want to put the upper plate on, that'll be the installation for that. So I'm going to leave this piece off, even though, normally it would go, but this piece gets replaced with this top plate. So I'm, for this build, I'm just going to leave this off. All right, there we have it. So what I want to talk about real quick is the importance of this M2C plate. And not only is it a stiffener, but this thing here, what it's designed to do, and again, this is what the zip tie in here is for, is you take this bracket here, for instance, when you're bashing this bracket, yeah, it holds the motor down, keeps it from going down. But I've landed roughly and violently many times on the roof. And when you land on the roof, there's no motor support whatsoever this way. The only thing in there is this thin plate of metal that's wrapped around this plastic. And what I was doing was I actually bent mine up a little bit. So the M2C piece not only is a stiffener that goes here and literally attaches to the rear end of the motor, but you can zip tie it down to the actual motor. So you're actually holding the motor down to the mount, instead of just letting it flop and hang in there. Because like I said, until they come up with something to stiffen this up, the M2C kit basically takes care of that where you really don't even need to. But that's one of the reasons why this piece is off and gets replaced. All right, so I think what I'm going to do next is do the box. I'm going to show you guys what we do with this. I'm just going to go ahead and do it off camera. But what I do here is I'm going to take this stuff out and basically going to cut this box in half right here, right where it's thin at. And then it gives you a chance to keep your power switch mounted right where it is, kind of. It'll be underneath the underneath this upper plate a little bit. because the upper plate comes in right above here. But what I do is I just dremeled this here down and I set it all on top of this, because I don't think with this box, you know, the power switch is too accessible. So we'll see. Mine, I didn't use this on mine. I just, like I said, I made it flat right here. So I'm going to try to salvage this box and keep this whole half of the box, including the top, from the screw over intact. And we'll see how that goes for this one. If I run into any problems, I'll pop the top off and make it flat like I did with mine. But the main point of this is to make sure that we transfer the servo mounts, which you're going to need. And then, like I said, we can reposition the ESC, because this box won't take anything bigger anyway. So if you ever want to upgrade to a max, like max 8, hex 10, or I'm sorry, like a hex 8 ESC or something along that line, then you would need a bigger box anyway, or to remove this part of the box. But the ESC plate is going to mount to the truck right here, and then it fits right in this cutout. So, you know, that just goes all hand in hand. So that's what we're going to wind up doing with this. So I'll be back. I'm going to alter this, and then we'll get that mounted. I'll leave the servo unattached because we're going to put a new servo in this anyway. But like I said, I just want to get the box done and show you guys what I'm talking about there. All right, so I'm going to hold off on this for a minute because I broke my Dremel tool, the head of it, doing my Kaiju body. So I can't really do anything with this right now. I got a new part coming in. It'll be here probably tomorrow or the day after. So I'll get this done. Probably finish up this video tonight as far as getting this chassis back together, getting it all ready to go for the upper plate kit, and might even get the motor mount installed tonight. And then, of course, you guys won't see any difference. I'll just be back a day later finishing up this video, and it'll all be part of the edit, so it won't matter. But either way, you know, that's we're bypassing that for now. So we're going to get back to the install real quick. All right, so we're done here for now. I know I got two screws here left out, but I've started doing this, and I'm not sure if I can, the piece that mounts here, I'm not sure. I know it goes over top of this screw. Pretty sure I got dropped this rear end, so I started to put all that together. I'm like, you know what, I better hold off. But it is, for most part, back together if you were only doing the bottom chassis. But as I show in the M2C testing that we did, this is what we started with, and it didn't stop the chassis bends. It didn't stop the rear dog boat bend. So it would still have some flex, even under hard bashing, which would allow that dog bone to bend. So this is a good solution. It's an awesome chassis. It makes this truck a tank, but it makes this truck a tank with this piece. So if you needed something first, this is what you want first. If you're going to upgrade your truck and over time, get this first, because this is what matters more. This is what fixed the dog bone bend, even with the stock chassis. Again, it's just a tank with the upper and bottom, both being 775 4mm plates. But all right, let's get it going real quick. I'm going to see if I can see if I can't get this to work without having to take this apart again. It's been a while. And this is, of course, much different than mine as far as the anodizing goes. It's got some nice M2C engrades in it, so I actually might change mine out. I don't know. I got the original unanodized one that I painted black, but you know, the stickers where I had it at, when you peel them up, they actually came off. So this is a pretty cut and dry piece right here. Ultimately, it's going to go on the truck like this. And we just got to do a few things to make it bolt right up. And we'll start with the motor, locking down the motor and putting the other motor piece in. All right, so this is the piece here. This is going to go under the motor. So I think I might be able to make this work. We'll see. This is going to go under the motor here, and this is what you actually put your zip tie around. The zip tie goes on the bottom of this and goes over top of the motor. These are the, they go here. So they lift the chassis plate, because we have to lift it evenly. So these go here on the side. So we're going to have to remove these bolts as well. So that's those. This is the hard Delrin piece here that goes over top of this little nub here on this piece. And it's got a drill bit here because the top of this, it is kind of open, but Mitch just gave us a drill bit in case you want to pop that out a little bit. But if you start threading that screw through, it goes through and grabs. You really don't need to drill it. I didn't drill it originally the first time, but it's nice to have the drill bit there if you need to. So he gives us both of those. And then this piece goes on the front here, right on top of both of these. And that just, again, gives a little bit of gap filler from what you can see right here. Of course, it's sitting up right now, but it's just that gap filler here. Gives you a spot to mount to. So, all right, let's get this motor mount assembly done and see if I can get this done without disassembling this. I said this is Delrin. I apologize. This is a aluminum. This is metal. So I forgot. I think maybe our originals were Delrin, but that is anodized black. So we'll set that aside. Okay, so that we can get under the shaft. So let's get that long screw in there and get the shorter screw out. All right, so I'm going to slide this piece in, but what I do remember now, the piece here, the reason the drill bit is included is because this is threaded already. So what you're doing with the drill bit is actually removing the threads because it threads into this piece right here on the bottom. So you're not going to need the threads here. You pretty much are sandwiching. If you put this on and try to leave the threads there, this is loose. So all I did was punched it straight down. No problems, you know, and right in and out. So now the screw should almost go right down in there. A little bit better. And there we have the rear. Rear brace. Now I've never done this with this motor, so slide this all the way up. This should be out of the way. All right, now it's adjustable, which the other motor mount wasn't, like I was talking about. So this I can slide up or down. So if you put a 4274 on it, you can drop one right in and just adjust this slider piece. Get semi-tight, not all the way yet. Do the other side. All right. So now again, I've never done this with this heat sink on here, so I'm very limited on my spacing here. There's not much room to come over top of this, so I might have to take this heat sink off just for now. Like I said, my 4274, I don't have a sink on it, and that's what I'm using on mine, so this wasn't a problem for me. So I'll worry about that later. And you can go get yourself some metal zip ties, and they'll work better for you. Yeah, you know, I would definitely get a metal one. I haven't got a metal one yet. Mine is still holding tight. So I'm not telling you need one. I'm just saying that if you want the best secure grab hold on the motor, you should use a zip tie that's aluminum or metal. All right, so I got a better zip tie. See the difference here in length. So this will definitely not give me any issue. So if you got a zip tie, you might want to make sure you have one, because I don't know how many of them came like that. This is a heavier duty one anyway. This is the one I used on mine. All right, so make sure you're on there. Give it a real good pull. I like to slide this down under out of the way.
So now this motor is not going to, when you take an impact on the roof, it is not going to come up off of this motor mount, especially once we go to tighten all this down. So I'm going to go ahead and cut my zip tie off here and then go ahead and start tightening these two down. So I want to be sure to mention as well, real quick, there's two sets of holes in here. The top hole that's in this metal piece here, the top hole is going to be for the stock motor. The bottom hole is going to be for when you put a 4274 or something on there. You're going to need a little more room to drop down. So that's, right now, that's at the highest position for the thinner can motor. So I just want to point out, if you're doing stock, use the top hole. If you're using 4274, use the bottom hole. All right, so you can see now with this on, there's no gap here with the motor. This is completely tight to the motor. These are locked down tight. That motor is not going anywhere up or down, and it's not going to bend that little piece of aluminum that's in here that, you know, is technically the motor plate. So it's an awesome setup, man. Mitch came up with an awesome design with this, and it's definitely holds tight, man, and it definitely changed a big part about this truck, you know, which was that adjustable motor mount, which sucked, and you had to either shave it down or, you know, just fiddle with it. It just wasn't worth it, man. This is so much nicer, so much tighter. Even if you bought it and only put that piece on it, it's still a better motor support. But, you know, we're going to toughen this whole thing up when we're done. So the next thing we want to do is we're going to get these screws right here out, and we're going to take the screws right here out, and we're going to put the piece on there, and then we're going to put the two pieces on there and lay the plate on top of it. Come on, baby. Sometimes you get lucky. Oh, I got lucky with this one. Sometimes you get lucky with these, man. These are in that service saver post, so sometimes you got to take one of them out for the top or bottom, and the whole damn shaft will spin. So I lucked out with one. I think I got two. I sure did. All right, so Mitch also gives us replacement screws for those. They're longer to go through this plate. All right, so the ESC plate on this one is a little different than the original prototype that I got. So this actually is going to be needed. These drill bits here, I'll show you what they are and pretty much what you got to do. So you see we got this big screw, this other thinner flathead, we got a button head here, cap head, and a smaller flat. Alright, so what these are for is this new ESC plate attaches. You're going to drill out this hole from the bottom, just punch it out so it doesn't have any thread. This is threaded already, so you're screwing into that there. Same thing we did in the rear. We're going to punch a hole through this. That goes there. That's your two main holds. And then you got that piece right there that this bolt right here goes into. And that's your new ESC mount. So this piece rides right underneath the shaft. And then we'll be able to mount our ESC right here next to the shaft. It should be far enough away from the shaft. Plus we got a little overhang here if we need it. But mine mounts a little differently, but I actually probably like mine a little better. But this one definitely feels more secure because I didn't have mine mounting to these two spots. So he must have decided after he, you know, came up with this idea for this one to go ahead and do that with this. So I didn't know this was different. I would have pulled this out before and looked at it. But it's going to screw in here. We're going to punch these two out, put two screws there. As far as what that other screw is, now mine screwed to the bottom of the Max 8 ESC or the Hex 6 ESC or the Max 6 ESC. So maybe that one screw here is to hold one side of it and then use 3M tape at least to give it like a one partial screw hold. I don't know, because like I said, there's four screws there and I only see the access for the three. So I'm really not sure what the fourth one is yet. But time will tell. So we'll get it going and we'll see what it looks like. I'm going to go ahead and punch out these two holes real quick. All right, so the 4mm screw black drill bit is for this hole here. The silver one is for this hole here. So we'll have, which I now have in my drill bit. This one's going to go right where that hole is. So we're going to pull that screw out, drill that out real quick. All right, so let's put this longer screw in, get this going. I'm going to drop it in. Let's turn this thing up a little bit. All right, that was done. I really, you know what, guys, I'm liking that. I love it. I like it a lot because it actually just, I felt it, I could feel it sandwich that plastic piece down there too. So it's got a really good hold on the front of that piece as well, which should help. This should actually help keep the front dog bone as well in a straight position. Not that it wouldn't before, but it's just an extra brace between these two points. Even though it's not a top brace, but it's going to take pressure off the top brace because it is down there bracing this bottom piece. So I do like that. I'm going to have to, I'm doing this conversion probably to mine, get rid of those prototype pieces. It's a very solid piece there. I'm at a standstill kind of because of just this last part. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get that drill bit in. I'm going to postpone my video for now, but when we come back, we're going to go ahead and have that box cut. We'll be installing that box, and we'll put this plate right on top, guys. We're almost done, and then we'll take a good look at the final result. All right, so I had to do some things in the meantime, but that's why the background looks a little different. But other than that, we went ahead and got this cut off. My Dremel tip came in. We're all set here. This is what I've discarded, so we're not going to need that. And as you see, if you take this and put it into the chassis with the holes applied, and you put the other two screws in the bottom. So now we have the ESC mounted. So if you want to put a larger ESC, you have that there. Of course, I'm just running this one stock for this setup, just to do the top plate and the chassis. But that's a smaller one. You have much more room if you wanted to put a bigger one on there. And then, like I said, that's there. So now, if you're careful and you do it right, this is what you should have left for the top. I started messing up right there. I got a little too close, but it still serves the point. Once I go to put this back on, it will go on here and it will allow me to hold my wires down the middle as well underneath. So just if I want to tuck some of these wires, since I pretty much took out the part where all the wires were tucked down into, you can get a little bit into here and then you kind of wrap it over and double do it in here and kind of holds them in place. But again, that's going to kind of be hidden because it's going to go underneath of this plate. So you're not going to see it anyway. So regardless, don't worry about too much cable management with that. It's not a big deal. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and get it back together. I'll get this attached. We'll get the top plate on, get the cable management done up pretty good, and move on. Be right back. All right, so now if you did that right, this is what it could look like. Where, I mean, pretty much we got the power button back in its spot. Got this piece coming up. You really can't do much about this because that's where the head is. I mean, they don't really leave any room at all for that. Did the best I could right here with the wire management coming out because it just really isn't a ton of room in there for these wires all to fit. And I looks like I clamped that cable. I got to back that off a little bit. But yeah, it'll all feed up into here. And then you have your little bit of excess right here, which is no big deal. Again, it should be all covered up. But all right, we're ready for the top plate. All right, so ready, before we can put this on, get open up this package next because we're going to replace four screws here, two on each side. And we got to add these little spacers here. And the spacers just give the height needed to raise this up to make it the same height as this and where it's going to mount at back here with this top plate. With the motor mount and these rear diff mount. So we'll go ahead and pop this open and get these out. Now you got these four screws here, which are going to be replacing these four screws with the top plate. That's why they're extra long. These two are going to go basically here, which if you already have these, I have to check these. Maybe these aren't as long, but if they're not as long, maybe that's the difference. If they're the same size, you probably don't need them. These three are going to go here into this, and then I believe here and here, which are going to be here and here. So that's those three. And these two little guys, we'll get to when I get to it. I can't really place which one those are, but we'll figure it out as we go, and I'll let you know once I get there. All right, so now they're out, and I would also recommend going ahead and taking out the rear and front screws. Just get them out of the way because we're going to need them out anyhow. I'm getting ready to put the top plate on, so it's a good thing just to get them out of the way. Now these just lay right on there on both sides. Not going to make it completely tight yet, just because I want to be able to make sure my holes align pivoting wise. All right, still got a little bit of play there. So now I want to, I'm going to put the ones in the mounts. The next, I'm going to use some Loctite, thread lock, whatever you want to call it, just to kind of keep that in there. I mean, these are aluminum, so we can just go ahead and thread lock them just to help them securely stay in. So beating it up, bashing it up, you don't want those screws to back out. All right, now the two fatter screws back up top. All right, so the other two screws just lock in that divider piece. So these screw right down into that M2C spacer right there. So I guess just to kind of hold that in place and add extra security to the center. And that's it. We used all of them. Now I'm just going to go ahead and tighten up all the other screws. All right, guys, there it is. I mean, it doesn't get much better than this as far as a inexpensive truck that you can just bash and not really think twice about, at least from my experience with it. And, you know, I don't hide anything, guys. You can watch my videos. I show me beating this truck up, man. You know, there's no smoking mirrors. It's not me, you know, pulling the truck off the side, fixing something or downplaying what's broken. It is what it is. I mean, I just haven't broken a lot with this truck at all. And again, I've covered every single time I've broken something on this truck, so you guys can go back and see it. So the only thing I would like to do if I were to get this open, or telling you guys if you're going to go through and do this and you haven't done it yet, I would have put the upgraded aluminum steel spur on there, but they're out of stock on them right now, so I couldn't do it, or I would have done it. But you got your power switch in place right there, so you still have access to it, easy on and off. You got a little place for your antenna to come up. Mitch really did a great job on this, is actually taking everything into consideration and doing what he needed to do to make sure that this was a functional and, you know, practical upgrade. And he sure covered it, man. So I'm very impressed with this. I'm going to go ahead and get this back together. I'm going to have this up for a raffle as well, my Facebook page. But this truck's definitely going to make somebody happy. Anybody, especially somebody that hasn't had a chance to experience it, or maybe they haven't and don't have the upper plate or the bottom chassis, just to see the difference. That's what this is going to be. So, and I may I got some comparisons coming up with the Haas and Traxxas Max once they come in. They should be here probably
sometime next week. But once they get here, I was thinking about doing a 4S comparison as well to this, just because with this M2C, what I have right here on this truck is less than even what the Traxxas Max is. And there's some benefits to this truck that obviously the Max doesn't have, or I wouldn't be bringing it up. But we'll go over some of those things when I get those trucks in, take a look at that. So stay tuned for that. Probably also compare the new MT-10E that'll be here next week, and we'll compare that probably to the Haas while we're at it, you know, because I got them coming in. But either way, guys, I'm going to go ahead and get this back together, get the battery straps on this, go ahead and put my aluminum servo mount on here. I do recommend anybody doing this, you might as well, again, if you don't have one and you haven't upgraded this, you might as well upgrade this at the time, because if it hasn't stripped on you yet, just consider yourself pretty lucky. But that's something I'll do. I'll power it up once I get it all on, run my wires, set everything else. Everything else is perfect as is, man, and runs like it should, just from factory. You know, all your cables reach. Everything's good. So I'm going to go ahead and get this dressed back up. There's no need to film all that. Be right back. Before I hook this up, just kind of go over this. A lot of people make this mistake when doing this, and they go ahead and just hook everything back up the way it was. But we're going to change out the servo horn anyway, so when we do this, we got to do it with the truck on and with the remote control on so that we can center everything. So I'm going to go ahead and get this horn off here. We'll put the new aluminum one on. All right, now my new one. Just try to find out which hole would be best to keep it closest to stock. Looks like the middle one. Get your thread lock. The aluminum horn, and that thing should never come off there. And then we just got to now power everything up, make sure it's all centered, and then we can line it. Now, if you're doing this and you've had this truck for a while, obviously you want to make sure your steering trim is centered, which mine is right facing down, right at zero, so we should be good. So everything's centered. I'm going to now center the wheels. Just make sure that this is as straight as it possibly can be. So mine slipped right on. Now we'll see. It's about as center as it can be. And of course, you can always adjust it with the steering trim just a little bit once you get the tires on and see if it's exact, but you know, doing it this way just gets you the closest to possible center as you can. Yeah, you know, do it this way, you'll get guys saying, "Oh man, I hooked it up, my servo's all the way to the right, you know, I can't figure out why," and that's usually why. So that's all we needed that for. I've already checked the rotation of the motor for these wires being flipped. So if you go to hook this back up and your motor's running backwards, you probably just got these two outside wires flipped. So I've already got all that hooked up. This truck's literally ready to roll. I'm going to pop a screw in there, and we'll be ready to go. All right, guys, here it is, man. This is the finished product. And, you know, of course, with my couple extra touches, again, guys, we cut the box in half. We've salvaged that box. We salvaged the servo mount. Got access to everything there. Got your wires here laying nicely. Everything's still usable here, as well as holding the wires in from flapping around. This brace supporting the front just makes this whole truck a beast. And then, of course, we sandwich it with the 775 rear chassis, or the lower chassis, and the ESC plate that's also acting as a brace in there. So, I mean, the truck right now, if you can go get some T-bones from for the Terra Moto 10 and put yourself some front ones in, get them blank, and just drill your own holes, or, you know, you might have to move two holes, I believe, in the front. The rear is almost perfect, with the exception of the braces here, where it attaches here at. The Terra Moto 10 has an extension piece here that comes out, so you have to drill your holes in closer for this. But other than that, it's exact. That's why I tell you, get it blank. It's just really easy to punch your own holes and stuff in. But that combination of, you know, the M2C stuff with the T-bone stuff, absolute tank, guys. This truck is a tank. I can't explain it. There's not a better word for it. Mitch did a great job strengthening this truck up, considering what we were having issues with. And I do want to show you guys one other thing real quick. All right, so I want to give Red Cat at least an A for effort here. This is the newest version of the Landslide. You know, nothing's really changed except for they did put a bracing from here to the mount right here. So they do now have that extra bracing, which is nice. It will help with the front for sure. Absolutely better than nothing. Not as good as what M2C is doing here because there's literally no rear support. And then, of course, you're still stuck with the motor mount here that, you know, the slide style that's supposed to raise it up. But when you go to put a fatter motor in or you're trying to find some in-between meshing, because this is the auto mesh gearing, as I've explained on that, it's not as good. So, yes, great that they're coming with that. That's going to do people that want to buy the truck for sub $300 and not have to worry about that kind of stuff right away. That's going to help you out with the front end for sure. It is definitely not going to do anything for the rear end, as they couldn't come up with something. I'm sure if they could have, they would have. But again, with what Mitch did, there's no need. You know, if you're going to buy an upgrade like this, or if you know, do this to your own, even the money that you would spend on that, probably paying $20 for this linkage piece or 15, whatever it is, and not having support in the rear, you can put that towards the M2C racing kit. So even the top plate alone has been proven to stop the chassis bends. So if you didn't need the bottom plate, that's just an addition. I just did it for the video. That's the M2C truck landslide. I just wanted to make it the full kit of everything they offered. But that's it, guys. I know I've covered this before as well, but I'll probably be cutting the landslide or the Terra Moto 10 shell out for this one. And it fits like a gem. I mean, it fits like it belongs. It's an awesome body. One of the favorite bodies from Red Cat, hands down. So I'm probably might do a clear or maybe this one here. I just wanted to get it out. This truck just goes perfect with this. So but that's it, guys. I appreciate you all for watching this. And I know this video is long overdue, but I had to wait for them to re-release these because I ran out of them and I lost a bunch of video footage. I had done this once before, but I lost all my video footage and hard drive crashed. So of course, the follow-up to the originals, or the original was on there, but the follow-up is the one I'm speaking of, where it was actually with the M2C parts that came in just like this. All right, well, that's all I got, guys. So again, hit me up in the comment section if you have any questions, and I appreciate you guys for watching. Thanks.